Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to continue with our discussion of entropy and spontaneous reactions, but now introduce two new variables, enthalpy delta H or Gibbs free energy delta G. Now, let's take a look at this example. It says, consider the spontaneous fusion of ice at room temperature. For this process, what are the signs for delta H, delta S, and delta G? Before we even take a look at this question, I'm going to give you guys some notes to help you realize what the sign of delta H and delta S can be. So we're going to say here, if we're going from gas to liquid to solid, what's happening to our molecules? Our molecules are coming closer and closer together until they reach the solid state in which they're frozen in place. We're going to say technically here, we're forming bonds. We're forming intermolecular bonds. Molecule A is coming close to molecule B, so they're forming an attraction to each other. It's not a real bond, it's more of an intermolecular force bond. And we're going to say here, if you're forming bonds, then we must be releasing energy in order to form those bonds. So delta H would be negative. On the opposite end, we're going to say delta S, what's happening to the entropy? We're becoming more ordered. Bonds are coming closer and closer together. Now you're solid. So your entropy should also be negative. Now, if we go the opposite way, we go from solid to liquid to gas, what's happening? We're breaking these intermolecular bonds. And remember, to break bonds, you have to first absorb energy or heat and use that energy you just absorbed in order to break those bonds. If you're absorbing energy, your delta H will be positive. At the same time, our delta S, what's happening to the molecules? They're becoming more and more like gases. Gases have tons of chaos. So chaos is increasing, so delta S should be positive. So this is the way you have to understand it. Whether you're forming bonds or breaking bonds will help you figure out, are you having a delta H and delta S that's positive, or are they negative? Now, if we go back to the question, it says fusion. Now, the name can be a little bit deceiving. Scientifically, fusion means melting. When it comes to phase changes, fusion just means melting. And if you're melting, what phases are you going between? So remember, what melts? We're going to say if you go from a solid to a liquid, you're melting. And if you're going from a solid to a liquid, what are you doing to bonds? You're breaking them. Therefore, delta H and delta S should both be positive. And because of that, that takes out B, C, and E. So our answer is either A or D in this question. Now, the next important piece of information I give to you is the word spontaneous. Because I say it's spontaneous, remember, we've said this earlier. If it's a spontaneous reaction, delta G has to be negative. If it's spontaneous, delta G is negative. So that one word that I used makes it answer choice D. Okay, so just remember, are you forming bonds or breaking bonds? This will help you figure out delta H or delta S. For delta G, you have to think in your head, does this naturally occur? Does it make sense for this to occur? If it does, then it's a natural process. And if it's a natural process, it's spontaneous. If it's spontaneous, delta G will be negative. Now, knowing this, I want you guys to attempt to do the next question on your own. So here we say, consider the freezing of liquid water at 30 degrees Celsius. So just remember, does freezing mean you're making or breaking bonds? This will help you figure out what delta H and delta S are in terms of signs. Then ask yourself this question. Freezing of water at 30 degrees Celsius, is that a spontaneous reaction, which is natural, or is it non-spontaneous? If it's spontaneous, delta G will be negative. If it's non-spontaneous, delta G will be positive. Knowing all this, try to answer this question as best as you can. Once you're done, click on the explanation button and take a look at a video of me explaining how to approach this problem. Good luck, guys.